of the women I work with, there's some trauma, there's some indoctrination about their body. It's very rare that I meet a client, a female client, who says, I totally love my body, every aspect of it. I am just in love. And, you know, that's it. There's always something to pick out, it seems, that isn't okay. And one of the main tenets of Tantra is acceptance, accepting all within you, because we are not here to make something good or bad that was just here for us. We didn't choose it, right? This is our body. So I'm not saying just live with your body and that's it. You can still want to make improvements in your body, but the first and main improvement to make in your body is self-love and acceptance. So body image is absolutely huge, because if you're not accepting your body, if you're not in love with your body, you're telling your body it's not okay. And that's not a safe space to be in. That is, even for self-pleasure, you know, love your body, explore your body, play with different parts of your body slowly, presently, with breath. And then when you take that to a partner, they're going to feel this confidence and this love energy coming off you. And that's going to really spark, A, inspiration in them to feel and do the same. But B, it's going to spark a passion and a fire in your love life, in your intimacy, and in your sexuality.
Totally. Are there practices that you recommend that women do in order to facilitate this kind of self-love with their own sexuality and body?
Yeah, there's definitely a few different exercises. I like to have any of my clients really start off and do some mirror exercises. So looking at yourself nude in the mirror. For some people, that's really scary. For me, I just like to walk around naked anywhere and everywhere I can. But for some people, that is really scary to really look at yourself. I mean, it's shocking how many women have never even really deeply looked at their yoni, their vagina. And to just see what it looks like from different angles, you know, get one of those hand mirrors and just look at it and honor it and really just see the journey that it has been on with you. And that's a really beautiful step to start coming into self-love and working on body image. And then there's different types of self-pleasure rituals that I recommend for my clients that will have you exploring and honoring your body in a new way. I talk to a lot of men too, whose ritual around, you know, self-pleasure has been, you know, sitting on a computer chair, looking at pornography with a bunch of tissues. Yeah. And, you know, that is just not a sacred way to treat your sexuality. Compare that to setting up a beautiful space in your home, lighting candles and scented candles you enjoy, putting on music that you love, and getting some nice oil to explore yourself, because the king gets to be the king. And there's such a discrepancy of how men treat their sexuality versus how they could if they really stepped into consciousness and a tantric path. And like I said, I mean, this is not the way, but it is a way to see if there's healing available or expanded pleasure or ways to fix things that you feel like aren't working in your life. So try it on. Give it a shot. It sure beats masturbating in front of a computer screen on an old sticky computer chair, you know?
Agreed. But I'm super curious if you find that it's kind of harder to get men that are used to masturbating in that way to change their patterning. Do you find it harder for men than it is for women to kind of go towards a more conscious way of being sexual with themselves?
It's a little hard to say, because the men and women that come to me, generally, they're ready. They're coming into this space either I've tried everything, or hey, I want to be a conscious, you know, man with my sexuality. So the ones that come to me, it's not as difficult as you would think. If I were to just work with the general population and be like, hey guys, here's what we're going to do. Because one of the first things I do is I put them on a 1 week porn cleanse. Again, not to say that porn is bad, but, and it's not to say that if you do, you know, masturbate to porn in that week that you're bad, but just to say that let's just see what comes up and figure out what is urging you, what is making you go masturbate. Because I remember personally when I used to masturbate to porn that I was using it as a procrastination, and I would use it as a quick, like, dopamine hit. It was something to make me feel better when I was feeling alone. And it wasn't just a beautiful experience of exploring my body. Sometimes I used it as a reward when I was on a project or doing something. I'd be like, okay, when this is done. And I remember even in college, it was like, well, when I finish this many pages, I'm going to go treat myself. And, you know, that is not really how I want to treat my sexuality
I
anymore.
love your honesty.
So, absolutely. And this is what men also need. They need to see that their brothers are talking about stuff, because men don't talk about their masturbation habits or pornography. It's not the things that they're talking about behind closed doors with each other.
Totally. And is there a difference in the way that you feel your, how you used to feel when you were masturbating, as opposed to when you have like a sacred sexual experience?
Yes, absolutely. I just remember in those days when I would ejaculate, I would just feel like, ugh, like I just feel like drained. I'd feel like it was icky. And then you see whatever your pornography you're watching, and it's just like, oh man, this is what I
Then you
just
just want
like,
to turn it off.
yeah. And it's just like, it doesn't have a good feeling. You don't feel energized. You know, it's with more of a conscious sexuality. When I have conscious sex with a partner, man, after that, I just feel like I'm looking into the eyes of a goddess, and I'm the king and she's the queen. And now, what else are we going to create? What else are we going to do together? Like, it's
Oh,
an
it's
energizing
fantastic.
experience.
That's amazing. So, can you tell us about your current and future offerings?
Absolutely. So yeah, they're constantly evolving, but my main offering is a tantric awakening experience, and it's a 2 to 3 hour session. I work with women and some men as well as couples. And it's an experience where we talk about your boundaries, your fears, your desires. And then we move into teaching foundational tantra, some coaching, working on energy work. So you really get to embody what tantra is for you and have that experience I described earlier, where you can really drop into your body and experience your truths. I also offer an 8-week tantra coaching course. So this is done virtually, and it's been much more popular, obviously, with everything going on in the world. And it allows you to have a personalized, customized course to work on whatever's going on in your life, to learn tantra, to do and embody different exercises. So I give you different exercise a week. And you have access to me regularly throughout the 8 weeks to ask any questions and to continue to explore your tantric path. So it's a beautiful way to come out of 8 weeks with a whole new relationship with your sexual energy, your sexuality, and also sometimes if I work with couples in that sense, for your relationship to be revived. I also offer workshops, public workshops, and then I also do private workshops. So I'm looking to expand and do workshops for gatherings of women, gatherings co-ed couples, where they want to bring me to certain places to do small workshops. I was actually thinking of a really good opportunity in the world of bachelorette parties. You know, a lot of women don't necessarily want to do the traditional bachelorette party. You know, going to the strip clubs or things like that is not exactly their vibe. Well, how about learning sacred sexuality? What a great way to move into a new realm in your life.
That's so funny that you mentioned that because I just did one of those 2 weeks ago and it was fantastic. So it's
Wow.
I was there instead of the stripper teaching them all, types of tantric touch and breast massage, and it was amazing. So
Isn't that the way the world should be going? How beautiful is that?
yeah. So you should definitely look into that. And what are your future plans? Do you have anything else planned that you want us to know about?
So right now I'm also creating a free online webinar, and it's basically just going to be able to give people a free introduction to what I teach. So that should be coming out in the next few weeks. And it's really a way for you to start to learn about Tantra, learn about this path, and really see if, you know, I might be a good fit for you. And then I offer a free exploratory call where we kind of just see what you're interested in and what might work for you, as far as working with me in the tantric path. Right now I am nomadic. I just put all my stuff in storage in Miami, and I typically do this every summer. And I travel the world. I typically go to the Tantra Festival in Sweden every year, which is the largest in the world, and I'm hoping to be able to do that as they moved it to I believe it's the middle of August. But I am constantly traveling to learn more about Tantra and bring those teachings to my clients, my friends, and continue to explore this tantric path, which is absolutely just unbelievable.
Well, that sounds fantastic. And thank you so much for taking the time to be with us on Divine Couples. I really appreciate it.
Thank you.
And if you would like more information about Justin Gottlieb, you can visit www.tantralovecoach.com. You can visit Justin's social media page, Tantra Love Coach, on Instagram. Thanks again for being with us on Divine Couples. You can feel free to check us out at www.divine-couples.com, and our social media page on Instagram is divine.couples, adding intimacy, passion, and healing to your lives. Thanks for joining us on Divine Couples. I am your host, Naomi Slater.
Join us next time to continue your journey in exploring the depths of your life force energy. Until then, this has been your host, Naomi Slater. If you have any more questions on this subject, feel free to reach out. Follow her on Instagram at divine.couples. And to see all of her offerings, visit her website at theworldwideweb.divine-couples.com.